Well, Nebraska was in development, let's say. Not a very large population. Actually, of the 3,000 men that actually participated in the war, you know, that was a very small group of people that were even available. So the population was small, not a lot going on. People were crossing the state area to get to other further western areas. So it was not very much in development. There was more activity, obviously, in Kansas. The concern was that much of the activity in Missouri and Kansas would flood into the Nebraska area. What happened was the original creation of the units authorized by the federal government, and that's all due to Abraham Lincoln calling for volunteers, was the fact that initially the Nebraskans volunteered because they thought they were going to be defending the western forts like at Fort Kearney. What happened was the war was going so poorly in the east that it became quite evident that the Union Army needed the Nebraskans to help fight in some major efforts that were going on eventually into Fort Donelson and Fort Henry in 1862. And many of these soldiers that did a volunteer were volunteering for a short time in hopes of doing what they needed to do and get back home. But like I said, as the war effort changed very, very quickly, they soon found themselves making a commitment in 1861, and eventually many of them did not return home until after 1863, 1864. One thing I can say, the Nebraska boys were extremely brave, and I must at this point talk about one of the key leaders of the 1st Nebraska Regiment, and there were the 1st Nebraska Regiment Infantry, and there was eventually a cavalry unit, and that was the leadership of Colonel John Thayer. And John Thayer reported to me and to Lew Wallace about his efforts and the soldiers that were participating under his command. They were very, very brave. They were tough men. They had fought earlier in parts of western Nebraska, and they were very capable fighters. And so when we called them to service and to serve with me at Fort Donelson, which was one of the first major victories in the West, they proved themselves very, very brave. The reports from General Wallace, as well as from Colonel Thayer, talked about how very, very brave they were, and they were with other soldiers that had been and had more service in the military to that time. Most Nebraskans need to be very proud of the fact that their state participated in two major battles that turned the tide for the Union. As I said, the battle at Fort Donelson was crucial. The Union forces captured some of the first Confederate soldiers in the battle of Fort Henry and Fort Donelson, which means we now had control of the Tennessee and the Cumberland River. But later on, in April of 1862, the 1st Nebraska fought at Shiloh. Now that was the battle that was very, very crucial for the control of the West. Had Shiloh had gone the other way, if the Confederates had captured Shiloh or not allowed the Union to capture Corinth, Mississippi, the whole war effort would have changed because the Mississippi River would have been and would have remained in the hands of the Confederate Army. By the fact that Shiloh falls in 62, Vicksburg falls in 63, and the 1st Nebraska was a crucial element on the second day of Shiloh that turned the battle. So most Nebraskans don't realize that they were a part of one of the most important battles of the Civil War.